Some Christmas joy for the National Party. Our latest One News Colmar Brunton poll showing that, with the support of ACT, they could form a government. It's our second poll in a row, putting the party in the driver's seat. Meanwhile, more bad news for Labor. Let's have a look at the numbers. National is down slightly, but it'll be no doubt happy with that 46. Labor's down 2 on 39. That's a two-year low. The Greens are steady on 7. New Zealand First steady 2 on 4. That's not enough to make it back into Parliament, though, without Labor's help. Good news for ACT, though, it's at 2%, meaning a friend in Parliament for David Seymour, assuming he retains Epsom and National support. The Opportunities Party, New Conservative and Māori Party all picking up one apiece. So how does all this play out in Parliament? Have a look at this. Close, but it's enough. National plus ACT's 2 seats would have them governing with 61. Labour and the Greens, though, agonisingly short with just 59 seats. Now, on these numbers, New Zealand First is out of Parliament. But, of course, you can never discount Winston Peters in an election year. Let's look now at preferred Prime Minister. Jacinda Ardern is on 36. That's down 2 points and her lowest result since taking office. Simon Bridges, though, finally in the double digits again on 10. Judith Collins on 4 and Winston Peters on 3. And not even an MP yet, but Christopher Luxon still gets a look in this too. For more reaction and analysis from Parliament, here's political reporter Benedict Collins.
Simon Bridges riding high, finishing the year just where he wants to be.
National has got momentum that we know how to get things done.
National's heavy policy focus making headlines.
Strike force raptor, strike force raptor, strike force raptor.
While Mr. Bridges has been showing off his skills.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
And handing out advice.
Just don't become a politician.
Support party ACT is chipper.
That's a very encouraging result.
It would double its number of MPs. To 2.
ACT has taken a series of principled and effective stances on difficult issues when nobody else has been prepared to stand up.
Labour, on the other hand, on the slide. Their worst result in 2 years.
Nobody loves me.
He's just a poor boy from a poor family.
But the Prime Minister insists she's not worried.
Every poll that I've seen in recent times has us faring better than we did at the time of the election when we were able to form the government.
The two main parties have been jostling for poll position for much of the last 2 years. While Labor had a lift after the Prime Minister was praised for her handling of the mosque attacks, in the last 4 polls, National has been in the lead, with a 7-point margin in the last 2.
We don't exist poll to poll. Instead, we focus on the things that we need to be doing, rebuilding New Zealand.
New Zealanders gave Jacinda Ardern and her team the benefit of the doubt. But what they're seeing at the end of the 2nd year is a government that's not delivering on its promises.
Winston Peters' recent donations drama.
Fake news.
And his behaviour.
If you were coming for a scrap, you come to the right place.
Didn't dent New Zealand First's popularity in this poll, but it'll need a boost or a seat next year to get back into Parliament. And remember, the government's got more announcements like this up its sleeve.
Next year, almost every single state school and kura in New Zealand will receive a one-off payment of up to $400,000.
Looking to keep the public sweet in election year.
And Benedict joins us now live from Parliament. How concerning do you think this is for Labor, Benedict?
Yeah, what is worrying Labor is that these polls is consistently showing National out in front and are consistently showing them sitting in the mid-40s. Day after day, National is running the same attack line that while the government's talking big, it's failing to deliver on key projects such as Kiwi Build. And I think that may be starting to hurt them. But Labor, when they look at National, they just don't think that when it comes to the crunch and people go to vote next year, that they're going to be able to bring themselves to vote for a party led by Simon Bridges, who many people do not believe is Prime Minister material. But another really important thing that this poll has revealed is that 13% of people have not made up their minds yet which party they're going to vote for. And that means there's a lot of votes still up to grab next year, and it means that come 2020, it's game on.
Political reporter Benedict Collins, thanks very much.